Not for a long time, Mrs. Wilson. Dad does not get to see a whole lot of daytime television. For the sake of you fellas who work days, I'd like to show you a little composite of what's happening during the day. We start with a newscast. There are so many things happening in the world of importance, elections and strikes and famines and coups and counter-coups, revolutions. Best way to stay informed is with an all-inclusive, comprehensive five-minute newscast interrupted by two commercials. To the news. Russia and the United States are at war. Missiles have been fired by both sides. Washington and Moscow are in flames. Details on these and other stories in just a moment. But first, this word about hair care. Come on, Marge, let's go. Barbecue's all set. Let's go, Marge. Come on, let's go to the barbecue. Oh, I can't. My stiff, stringy, snarly hair. I can't make the barbecue. Vroom, vroom. Who are you?
Hi, say, I'm Wendell the Witch. Hi. What happened to Wanda? Wanda's sick. Besides, what does she know about hairdressing?
Now, back to the news. On the local scene, another senseless killing today as police discovered the body of Irving Senseless lying in his hallway. Mr. Senseless was charged with loitering and his wife with littering.
You're right. The newscast is a little depressing. We'll take something a little lighter to pick up our spirits, a soap opera. Medical themes are very big on soap opera these days. I think it's because these programs make you sick.
And now another chapter in the seemingly endless drama of life and love and fooling around in a large metropolitan hospital. Welcome to Doctor Place. We'll be back to Dr. Place in just a moment. After this word about your complexion.
O'clock Monday morning, downtown, a busy office building, secretaries hurrying to work, the elevators crowded.
Oh, here comes that handsome Mr. Gland again. Oh, he's so handsome.
Good morning, Miss Burns.
Is that all he's ever gonna say? Good morning, Miss Burns. Couldn't he ask me who I like in a clay fight? He asked me where I got the combat boots? I think it's my complexion. I'll ask my complexion expert, the clerk at the drugstore with acne. And so anyways, I think it's my complexion.
Well, looking at your face, Miss Burns, you just might be right about that. However, you two now can have clear, smooth, fine skin with the new 7-day beauty plan. For you, it might take 6 months. However, just rub this cream into your face for 7 days, taking time out for meals, of course. You too will notice the difference.
Oh, here comes that handsome Mr. Gland again. I hope he says something else besides, good morning, Miss Burns.
Good morning, Miss Burns. I see your face cleared up. And now, back to Dr. Place. And now the patient speaks.
Oh, Doc, Doc, will I ever play the violin?
See no reason why you shouldn't with proper care.
Oh, that's great, Doc. I could never play it before.
Don't go away. It's time to play. Truth, ding, or penalties. And here he is, your master of ceremonies, that genial guy himself, Guy himself. Hi, thank you, Don Pardon. Hi out there, everyone. Fine, another nice house today. Well, yesterday we wanted to find out just how honest the people in our audience were. Are they as honest as they like to say? We chose a lady from the audience and gave her 10 $10 bills, each one in a separate envelope, each one marked with her name and address. We asked her to drop them around the studio to see how many would be returned. Well, we found out how honest people are. The lady cut out with the $100. However, we do like to reunite loved ones here on Truth or Consequences. We chose a lady from our audience before the show. You met her, Mrs. Tondaleo Breckenridge. She is off stage now in our soundproof booth. Doesn't know that we have flown her sister Congolia, whom she hasn't seen in 27 years. Flown her here from Maine on Basket Airways. And right now her sister is at the rear of our stage behind the curtain. We'll reunite these two loved ones here on Truth or Penalties. Don't let on, aren't we devils? Okay, cool. Now here she comes out. Next contestant, please. And your name?
Tondaleo Breckenridge.
Tondaleo, fine. It's a colorful name. Tell us, Tondaleo. If you don't tell the truth, you must pay the penalty. Your category, green Chinese pottery.
Oh, that's my lawn suit.
Fine. Are you ready?
Ready as you go, guy.
Fine. Here is your question. How many green Chinese pots in a dozen? Awfully sorry. You haven't told the truth. You must pay the penalty. We want you to walk now to the rear of our stage. Pull back the curtain and tell us what you see.
I don't see anything.
That's right. We were going to reunite you with your sister, whom you haven't seen in 27 years, but you blew the question. We sent your sister back to Maine. How about a cooking show? No daytime rundown is complete without it. Have you ever woken up at 9:30 in the morning with a bad hangover and worse stomach, and see some clown making marshmallow asparagus with a prune sauce? Take off that white hat.
Hi there, folks. Welcome to the cooking show. A lot of you folks been writing in asking us, how do you cook them damn grits? We're gonna show you today how you cook them damn grits. First of all, kind of get them grits down to shallot saucepan, kind of get a little water, just about an inch and a half water above them grits, get that thing boiling over good, you get a good high rolling boil going. Get that good high rolling boil, call it high rolling boil. Get that thing going good like that, you're going to drain them off a little bit, drain them off a little bit, get a little steam out there, drain them off a little bit, get them down a little bit of moist, a little moist, little patties. Make a fat little patty, two little fat little moist little patties like that. You put them in a hot skillet, a good hot skillet, lots of hot grease, get them brown on one side, get them brown on the other side, and then throw them away. They're no good, folks. You can't eat them damn grits. Hey.
Some veterans in the audience, right? Remember the first time you ordered ham and eggs in the South?